This week at NASA. A spacewalk on July 16th that was supposed to be about a 6.5-hour affair for Chris Cassidy and Luca Parmitano ended just 1 hour and 32 minutes in, after Luca's helmet began to fill with water.
Hey, Luca, can you clarify, is it increasing or not increasing?
It's hard to tell, but it feels like a lot of water.
Parmitano's okay, and a redo of the spacewalk to prep the ISS for a new Russian module is being evaluated. Meanwhile, back on the ground, astronaut Tom Marshburn was answering questions from high school journalism students at Washington's museum about the EVA as it was being shown live on the screen.
For a spacewalk, it's a combination of maybe going out on stage for the first time as the lead in a play and Christmas morning.
Marshburn also knows a thing or two about leaks in space. He and Cassidy fixed an ammonia leak outside the ISS during a spacewalk in May.
We want to not stand in the doorway, but open the doorway.
Up on Capitol Hill, NASA Deputy Administrator Lori Garver was part of a panel discussion at Future Space 2013. The annual event covers important issues related to space and supports educational programs and networking opportunities for graduate students and young professionals. It's apparently been there all along, but it took NASA's Hubble Space Telescope to find it. It is a newly discovered moon orbiting Neptune, the 14th moon we know about. Designated S/2004N1, it's only about 12 miles across, so small, even NASA's Voyager 2 spacecraft missed it when passing by Neptune in 1989. Better late than never. Hey, want to train like an astronaut? That was the focus for NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins and some American athletes discussing what it takes to be fit for missions to space during a Google Plus Hangout. Hopkins has firsthand experience in this kind of training because he's headed to the space station in September 2013 as a member of Expedition 3738.
The NASA Aeronautics Research Institute, or NARI, based at Ames Research Center, held a virtual conference where researchers from around the agency presented science results from first-round projects funded by the new organization. Projects ranged from the use of new materials in aircraft to improved noise-reducing aircraft designs to electric-powered green aviation solutions. NARI plans to introduce new projects and activities in the future as it expands the model for a virtual aeronautics research institute.
2, 1, fire! About 7 NASA space technology payloads took a quick ride high above New Mexico, courtesy of an Up Aerospace sounding rocket. The Spaceloft 7 suborbital flight, part of NASA's Flight Opportunities Program, gave the experiments about 4 minutes of weightlessness to be tested in a space-like environment. The goal is to help develop and advance future technologies in a new, low-cost way.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Timeless words from Neil Armstrong 44 years ago on July 20th, 1969, when he and Apollo 11 crewmate Buzz Aldrin landed on the moon. Then later, Armstrong again, eloquent and humble in his words, became the first human to step foot on another heavenly body.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Armstrong, Aldrin, and Command Module pilot Michael Collins returned from the historic mission 4 days later. And that's This Week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, or to follow us on Foursquare, Twitter, and other social media, log on to www.nasa.gov.